Hi everyone, Micah here from OpenSpace. I'm here today to show you a bit about how to look at moon phases in OpenSpace. So we're starting here with the default view of Earth that you get if you just launch our default profile. And we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna zoom out so that we can take a look at the Earth moon system. I'm just using my right click here to zoom out, and I'm gonna zoom till I can see the full moon trail. Now, one of the things when we're looking at the Earth moon system is I might want the moon trail to be a little more visible. So I'm gonna go here to our scene menu. I'm gonna go to our search and I'm gonna search for moon. And that's gonna give me everything that we have matching moon. And I'm gonna click on moon trail to open it. Once I open it, I have different settings that are available for the moon trail. And since I wanna change the way it looks, I'm gonna open appearance. The first thing I'm going to do is change the color, and I'm going to make it a little more red. Then I'm going to make the trail a little thicker by changing the line width. And finally, I'm going to make it so that we can see more of the full orbit by using the line fade parameter. As you drag the line fade parameter up, it will begin to complete the orbit, and as you drag it down, it will show less. So I'm going to leave it at something about 3 here, which will show us 3/4 of the orbit approximately. So now, as I orbit around, we can see a better view of the Earth-Moon system and how it's working. But if we want to show the moon phases, we're going to have to be able to see the moon. And so what we're going to do here is we're going to actually enlarge the moon to make it easier to see as part of this system. So again, I actually clicked on moon trail name again to close it. And now I'll click on moon name to open it. And I'm going to go down here to scale. And just like I used the slider for the line fade, I'll use the slider here to increase or decrease the scale of the moon. Now, it may actually be hard to see that the moon is growing because we're actually at a time where the moon phases in a new moon. So if I actually move my view around, now I can see the moon and I can see that it grows, that it has grown to 20 times its normal size. I'll actually use the middle click here and drag to the left to even out my view. So now actually the scale of about 20 actually works pretty good. I'm able to see the moon really well. And if I look back to Earth from Earth now and I look towards the sun, I can see that the sun is on the other side of the moon, and that's why I'm getting this phase. So now I can close our scene menu, and I'll use our time menu to actually advance time and watch the moon progress through its phases as it travels around the Earth. So here I'm going to use these arrow keys, which will step through some predefined time settings that we have, and I'll keep clicking it all the way till we get to about 12 hours a second. So now we are progressing the simulation at 12 hours per second. And here we have the Earth, and here we have the moon. I can move around to different views of the Earth-Moon system, and we can begin to see some of these phases happening. So we can imagine a line being drawn from the Earth to the moon, and which parts of the moon will be visible and lit based on where the moon, the sun, and the Earth are relative to each other. So I could even use the arrow again and just make it speed up a little faster. Now we're at 1 day per second, and so it would be 30 seconds for a full month. Now, this actually only shows one view of looking at this phenomenon as part of the Earth-Moon system. We also have another way that we can look at this view. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna zoom in a bit closer to Earth to look at this view here. And I'm going to click here on our focus menu and use a feature that we call anchor and aim. So I'm going to click on the anchor and click on Earth to anchor on Earth. And then I'll click on the telescope and click on moon to aim at the moon. Now I have the Earth and the moon traveling with each other. I can still use my left mouse to move around the camera, my right mouse to zoom in the camera. But now they travel together and their rotations are moving together. So if I actually use my H key here to hide the trails, now we can see just the Earth and the moon traveling together and we can watch these phases progress from a new moon all the way to a full moon. One of the things I might do while I'm showing this is I might turn off the trail of the ISS, so that way we don't see that orange blinking thing, so I can just click on that. You might also notice that the map of the Earth is incomplete because now we've traveled into the future to a point where the map of the Earth has not even been taken yet. So I'll actually open the layers for Earth and I'll turn off our combo layer and I'll turn on the static world imagery. Now we have a view of the Earth that is not changing based on time, and it's not trying to load a daily weather image. And as we're progressing here, there goes our full moon coming across to a half moon. And we see that as this goes around in a month, it will make a full cycle of the phases. If I zoom out here and I go to my scene menu, I might want to search moon and click on moon trail again. And I can now see just the moon's trail around Earth without any of the other planet trails in your way. So with a combination of these different techniques, you can use them to show the phases of the moon, and you can use the scale to kind of show it in whichever, as big or as small as you think you might need to demonstrate. Thank you for joining.